Okay, so right now there's a lot of buzz going on about augmented reality glasses. And this is really exciting for me because this is something I've been hoping and dreaming of for like 10 years or more. And more recently, some really famous YouTubers like MKBHD, for example, who I watch his content all the time, he even had a chance to try them out and try a couple of different brands of them. So in today's video, I really wanted to kind of comment and share not only my excitement for this technology, but more of my insights and some concerns I have as an eye care provider about how these frames, these glasses are designed and how this technology may or may not affect our brains or eyes visually. Because even though they sound awesome, even from like a science fiction standpoint, if they don't function and potentially cause more problems than they solve, then we might have an issue. So first of all, what are augmented reality glasses, or AR glasses? Augmented reality is a bit different than virtual reality, like we have the Apple Vision Pro, and even have the different Meta Quest models. Those are more of like true virtual reality headsets, where your entire kind of world can be made virtual, and you can interact in those. Of course, they do have some special features where you can kind of see through them, but it's more of like a full display of just showing the world around you. That's more virtual reality. Augmented reality, if you can imagine having a pair of glasses that you can put on, but has some elements of virtual images of maybe your phone messages or maybe a map or other types of overlays that go in front of your eyesight so that you can interact and see things in your world that other people around you won't be able to see. Now, this technology, as futuristic and science fiction as it could sound, is here. In fact, they have the new Meta Orion smart glasses, or these augmented reality glasses that have kind of been announced. And then you have some augmented reality that came from Snapchat as well. So really, with kind of where it's at, even though it's far from perfect, just the fact that they're able to start putting these things together is really exciting. Soon, we may be able to, you know, drive down the road with having to constantly peek at your phone or some sort of a screen over to the side to look at a map. You may just be able to have arrows and maybe even like a finger point down from the sky in your vision that points to where the coffee shop is that you're trying to get to. Or perhaps in like a virtual video gaming sort of sense, you will be able to see a monster or a dragon or so maybe like a Pokemon or something on the street that you need to catch. You'll be able to see that in real time with your own eyes through these augmented reality type of glasses that, again, other people may not be able to see. I can even picture going to a shopping mall and maybe picking up an item of clothing, looking at the barcode on the back, and these glasses will just read it and tell you exactly what that price is. There could be endless, limitless kind of applications for this type of technology. In fact, one thing that got me super excited, especially for like future video gaming, was in the MKBHD video that he just put out, where specifically looking at the Meta Orion augmented reality glasses, they found a way so that your hand gestures can control and send signals to these glasses and you can control what's going on. Rather than having to have a controller all the time, they found a way to have like a wristband that reads your electrical impulses from your brain to your hand. And so you can do different gestures with your hands that will communicate to this technology. And that honestly kind of blows me away. Just how they could potentially connect that to not just a wristband, to be making like full suits of clothing, whether that be like a full-blown like haptic suit like you've seen maybe in the Ready Player One movie or from the book adaption, or you can imagine having even like street clothes that have these types of haptic inputs built into them so it can read what you're doing with your body and potentially how your body's responding and just connect all that information to technology. That is mind-blowing to me. Like, I feel like we're just at the beginning stages where a futuristic, like true interactive video gaming system, kind of like Ready Player One has, could be in my lifetime. Again, I'm a video gamer, and that makes me really excited. Now, if I stop and pull myself back a little bit from just getting excited about what the technology may be able to do in the near future, if we really look at what is currently being made by Meta as well as Snapchat, at least in the MKBHD video. I know there's other companies that are sort of working on this, but just looking at what they currently have, there are some design things that I think is a little funny, and definitely they're far away from having a product that can truly be on the shelf and sold. In case you didn't know, at least with the Meta's design, the Meta Orion augmented reality glasses are not available. They're not being sold. This version will probably never be available to the public. They have a long ways to go. One big issue that I've had with a lot of the smart glasses that have come out in the last few years, including Ray-Ban's Meta Ray-Ban smart glasses, one issue is the size. As you can see in kind of these more recent videos, these Orion augmented reality glasses are pretty large. And certainly the size has to do with how much technology they have to pack into these frames, but there's a lot of other issues. Certainly, MKBHD showed off two versions, both one that has, I guess, that's kind of just black, and that's made with like magnesium, I believe he said. That allows it to kind of be a heat sink and dissipate more heat. They did have a clear version that he showed off for a second that does not radiate heat as well, so it maybe affects its battery life or its performance. But the size of frames does play a pretty big role. Not just, you know, like some people can pull off large frames and that's awesome, but it's not really just the cosmetic look or appearance of having large frames. When your glasses frames are big like that, whether they're made of plastic, metal, or they're filled with technology, you cannot adjust those frames. Glasses frames are not one size fits all, and if they're made and you can't adjust them, not even just like splaying them outward like this to fit somebody who has a larger head, a lot of people's ears are not dead level and their eyes are not centered aligned with the ears as well. So it's really important to have glasses frames that can be adjusted. And obviously if you have computer components inside of those glasses, you can't bend them, you can't fix them. And so those are some issues. The other part, and I could not find any information online about this, is whether or not these new glasses designs are capable of allowing prescription lenses to be inserted, right? Certainly for a lot of people, we're walking around wearing prescription glasses. Contact lenses are not available for everyone. So what do you do if you can't put the lenses inside of these? You don't want to be, you know, doubling up with different pairs of glasses. That'll look silly. So I just kind of question the future how they're going to do this, or if they're going to have the same issue that the Ray-Ban Meta glasses have, where, yeah, you can get prescription lenses put in, but you can only do that once. If you ever have a change in your prescription, whether it be from a medical issue or maybe in just a year down the road, how are you going to take out those lenses, put new ones in? You're not going to be able to. So that means you're going to have to buy a whole new set, a whole new frame. And I bet you, when augmented reality glasses come out, they will not be cheap. So that makes me kind of question if there will be further special type of, I don't know, insurance for higher level technology, things like this, like the way some people have insurance on their phone, you'll have insurance on your smart glasses so that if your prescription changes or they break or something happens, you can put new lenses in. Maybe. Now, beyond just the practicality of how they're designed and if that will ever really work or be easily adopted, I think the software capabilities of how these augmented reality kind of screens, I think how that works, I'm pretty excited of some cool benefits that I can see for that technology in terms of helping enhance eyesight for some people, but I'm also concerned of what it could cause for a lot of other people as well. For example, if you have the ability to display specific like virtual images in someone's field of view, I always kind of question how clear is that virtual image, right? If you're seeing your text messages on like a small window off to the side, will that be in focus for your eyes? How far away will it appear versus how close will it appear? Is it something that people will actively have to engage their accommodative system or their near focusing system in order to see that? I think if you don't need to activate your accommodative system, that could be a game changer for people who have like presbyopia. Like for a lot of people, once you get over the age of 40, there's a hard time seeing up close, and you always have to use like progressive glasses or bifocals or look for another option. And so if this type of technology allows for them to almost adjust magnification size of the virtual image that you're seeing in the lenses, then if somebody, again, if they're 60 years old, they can't focus up close, whatever they're looking at for a medium, perhaps it can be displayed and magnified in a way so that they don't have to accommodate. And so they could effectively eliminate the need for bifocals and progressives that way, especially if they somehow sync to a camera that's built into the lenses or the frame, because then you could basically take an image or a snapshot or have AI read what's in front of you. And again, it could eliminate that huge frustrating component about getting older in the eyes. Another cool way that I think this technology could help people is with people who have vision loss. For example, if somebody has a head injury and they've lost part of their visual field, like they can't see like 30% of their vision to their left, then perhaps this technology could give them a little warning sign that something is off to the side. That way they can avoid running into things, bumping into a counter, or bumping into somebody else that they don't know is standing off to their side. It could perhaps give them that warning sign. That could also be like a safety thing, a real cool benefit with these types of lenses. And then the third kind of cool idea that I had were this type of lenses, this technology could be really cool. And that was really more from watching MKBHD section on the Snapchat glasses. Those glasses have an ability to change how much transparency is in those lenses. So if you not just, again, seeing the augmented reality component, but being able to like filter out the other components of your vision that you don't want to see. Where I see that potentially being really helpful is in like driving situations. If the technology can not only give you augmented reality, but even survey your surroundings, if you're driving and the sun is coming down in that perfect spot where even with sunglasses, you're trying to like dodge, you know, where the sun's coming through and you're maybe closing an eye, it's really bothering you. Perhaps these glasses can selectively track where a really bright object is like the sun, and then selectively turn off the area in front of where that light is coming through in your eyesight. What I mean is that the lenses would be able to go opaque in the perfect amount of circular area of where the sun is coming in, and then you wouldn't have to deal not only with the direct blinding light of the sun coming in, but you wouldn't have to do kind of those dodge tricks like while you're driving in a car. These are definitely just kind of fun thoughts that I'm having, or ways technology can be applied with these types of augmented reality glasses. Assuming again that they're able to improve the design so that you don't have this massive heat sink that only has a battery life of like 2-3 hours. Now with all of these cool ideas and potential applications, and again I'm really excited about it, I do have some thoughts and concerns, because we certainly have seen a kind of a fallout from things like the Apple Vision Pro and other virtual reality headsets, as eye care providers, we're seeing a lot of people complain about things like eye strain, complaining that they're giving people headaches. There's potential issues of how these virtual images may interact with some people's visual systems, whether again it's triggering other symptoms like headaches, eye strain, or perhaps even affecting people's visual development, like young children and how they see the world. So I do have some questions. Unfortunately, I think because it's such early technology, and even the medical community, we don't really have access to this type of technology yet. So I think it'll be some time before we really have better answers of how these types of virtual images could affect the human brain, especially in our visual processing centers. But perhaps this technology could even be used to help improve the human brain's like visual performance in some ways. For example, there is a virtual reality tool called Luminopia, which is used for treating amblyopia or forms of lazy eye, which basically kind of filters out different types of images to each eye simply while a child is able to watch a favorite TV show, for example, which improves compliance. So there are potentially some advantages to this technology. in helping our eyesight. And I'd love to know your thoughts on this, not only with augmented reality, but potentially the virtual reality thing. Like perhaps if you tried the Apple Vision Pro and had eye strain, double vision, headaches, any sort of experience like that, whether it be with augmented reality or virtual reality, let me know in the comments, because this is definitely an area I think, especially eye doctors, we're going to be seeing this for going forward. So I'd love to hear your feedback. Otherwise, I think for my kind of final thoughts about this technology, again, I'm excited about it. However, I'm concerned that because of the challenges about the frame size, how it's designed, it not being necessarily super functional, being you can't adjust it, you can't really put glasses lenses in it. The battery life, at least looking at the Meta or Orion design, only has a battery life of like 3 hours. And I think for it to be kind of accepted and used regularly in our lives, it's going to have to be at least a 10-hour battery life. And it's going to have to be a lot more functional than just wearing this massive, bulky pair of glasses. Again, we got a long ways to go, and I always like to remind myself when this is like new technology, remember when computers first came out? Like, those things were like the size of a small house. So now we have this in our pockets. So this is just the beginning. Either way, let me know your thoughts. Thanks for watching. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in those next videos. Peace.